This video summarizes the work, facial color is an efficient mechanism to visually transmit emotion, which appears in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences. Most researchers agreed that human emotions correspond to the execution of a number of computations by the central nervous system. For thousands of years, people have studied the hypothesis that some of these computations yield visible facial muscle actions. These facial muscle articulations are known as action units, or AUs. Each AU defines a facial muscle action that can be visually interpreted by an observer. For example, contracting the middle section of the muscle in the forehead is observed as the raising of the inner corners of the eyebrows. This is called action unit 1, or AU1. Likewise, contracting the lateral portion of the same muscle yields a clearly visible raising of the outer corners of the eyebrows, called AU2. The assumption in these studies is that these facial articulations are not random and may be used to communicate emotions like happiness and surprise, as well as compound emotions such as sadly fearful. We note, however, that between our skin and these facial muscles, there is a very large number of blood vessels. In fact, as shown in this illustration, the number of blood vessels is surprisingly large. Why would that be? We hypothesize that the reason for this large number of blood vessels is to visually communicate emotion to observers by changing one's apparent facial color. Thus, our hypothesis is that some of the computations performed by the central nervous system vary the blood flow and/or its composition in a way that is A, unique to each emotion category or valence, and B, visible to observers as unique patterns of facial color. This means, as with action units, that there has to be a set of color features that is unique to each emotion category or other affect variables such as valence. Let us address each of these two points. We start with the first one. Are skin color changes consistent within expressions of the same emotion and differential between them? To test this hypothesis, we need to describe our images in isolumine color space. To understand what isolumine color is, consider the definition of an image in RGB. Formally, we define each pixel as a three-dimensional vector X with entries RGB. Typically, luminance is computed as a weighted sum of RG and B. As seen in the image, luminance indicates the amount of light that reaches each point on the surface of an object. This is called shading and specifies the shape of the object. Isolumine color is information in our RGB vector X once the luminance information has been factored out. This can be done, for example, by dividing the vector X by its luminance. Note that by doing this, the normalized vector has unit length. Thus, isolumine color space is given by a two-dimensional vector. The third dimension is the luminance. In this work, we use the opponent color model because it is believed to best describe human color perception in the retina. Let us see an example. Consider the image shown on left. We can decompose it into three elements. The first specifies the luminance. The other two specify the two opponent colors. Recall that if we convert these three images into grayscale, the top image would not change, but the bottom two would be blank because all their pixels have the same brightness. That is, there's no shading information in them, only color. Hence, we will only use the bottom two images to describe our facial expressions, since these are the ones that we hypothesize will change as a function of blood flow. Specifically, we first divide the face into a set of non-overlapping areas. Next, we compute the mean and standard deviation of the two color channels in each of these face areas. These values are used to define the feature vector of the isolumine color of the face image. We now use linear discrete analysis to uncover the color features that are consistent in images of faces expressing the same emotion, but differential across images of facial expressions of distinct emotions. This allows us to build a machine learning classifier that can estimate the emotion of previously unseen expressions using only the isolumine color. As we can see in this plot, the results demonstrate that facial color does indeed vary as a function of the emotion being expressed. We find the results to hold across people, gender, ethnicity, and skin color. The size of the circles in this plot specify the accuracy of our computer vision system at identifying each of the 18 emotion categories tested. Another way to plot the results is by indicating the proportion of times the algorithm successfully classifies each of the 18 emotions, as shown here. Let us now turn to the second part of our hypothesis, which states that the facial color changes identified by our machine learning algorithm are visible to human observers. Recall that our machine learning algorithm has identified the colors that are most discriminant of each emotion category. For example, here we show the facial colors our machine learning algorithm has identified for two emotion categories. Because these images are in isoluminant color space and plotted as a neutral face, they look a little strange at first, but the discriminant color information is still present. Can you identify the image that corresponds to a happy expression? If you need more time, you can pause the video. Okay, if you chose the right image, then your selection has the facial colors identified by the machine learning algorithm as most discriminant of happiness. Now, can you identify which is the emotion category conveyed by the colors in the right image? Again, you can pause the video if you need more time to decide. The answer is anger. That is, this image has the colors identified as most discriminative of this emotion. And here are the colors most discriminant of being angry, disgusted, happy, happily disgusted, sad, and fearfully surprised. To test whether these colors are indeed perceived as expressing these emotions, we performed a behavioral experiment. The experiment starts with a mask, followed by a fixation, and then an image pair. Participants have to choose which of the two images expresses the specified emotion. In a second experiment, we only provided an image and asked participants to assign an emotion label to it. In both cases, participants successfully classify most of the images. Finally, we wish to determine if these diagnostic color features are at least partially independent from the emotion information transmitted by action units. To test this, we added the diagnostic color features shown above to images of faces expressing emotion with action units. If color provides an independent signal from the AUs, then adding diagnostic color to these images would enhance the perception of the emotion. Here, we show two pairs of images. The first image in each pair includes the AUs of happiness and anger. The other two images have the same AUs plus the diagnostic colors identified by our machine learning algorithm. Can you tell which images more clearly express happiness and anger? Again, you can pause the video if you need more time. In both pairs, the left image includes the AUs and diagnostic colors. Recall, these added colors are isoluminant colors. Converting the images to grayscale shows the two images have the same shading information, and hence, only diverging color. Also note that the colors added to these images correspond to the same emotion expressed by the action units. That is, the added colors are congruent with the AUs. We can, however, add incongruent colors. For example, here, we have added the diagnostic colors of anger to the happy expression, and the diagnostic colors of happy to the anger expression. As before, we expect people to perceive the images with the congruent colors as expressing the emotion more clearly than the images with the incongruent colors. We tested this using a behavioral experiment. As we can see in this plot, participants generally selected the image with congruent colors as expressing the emotion category more clearly than the images with incongruent colors. In conjunction, these results provide the first evidence for the existence of a mechanism for the visual transmission of an emotion signal through the modulation of facial color. Importantly, this signal is at least partially independent of that used to transmit emotion with action units. These results suggest it is possible to visually transmit and detect emotion even in the absence of any facial muscle movement. If you wish to learn more, visit our website. You can also read our paper in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences.